Hey everybody, it's Warrior. Welcome back to Legend Dragoon. Last time we went and helped out the Knighthoods in the Marshland, but unfortunately it looked like in vain because they all got destroyed either by Sandors or the Dragon's Poison. And we showed off the Dragoon forms in the last part. So, anyway, this time around, we are going to go the way we were meant to go, which is to the west. And Marshland is great because there actually are some really good items here. We didn't really get any good items going the other way other than a new lance for Lavitz. And even that attack ball that I got, like I said, it has the potential to be great. But it really is up to you whether you even want to use it during a boss fight or just a regular fight. It doesn't matter. So, through here, if you want to go out of the dungeon, just simply go up on that path. Ooh, crocodiles. Two crocodiles. Crocodiles are pretty powerful, actually. They probably have the most physical damage out of anybody. They have a bite attack, and they also have a skull casting attack that they do that's their special attack. Ironically, their special attack is weaker than their regular attack, so go fig. As you see, it's pretty damn powerful. So, not really somebody you want to trifle with, the crocodile. I'd say easily the most intimidating enemy in the marshland. Also, in the last part, we got the physical ring for Rose. And Dart is constantly getting eaten alive. Well, you can't have that. Crocodiles don't have much HP anyway, so thank goodness for that. But they do hurt. They do hurt. So, if you want to get some really good items, go in the boat. And just explore everywhere you can. Because some of the items are fantastic and some are, alright. The Spirit Potion is not one of those items. But there is one item in particular here that I'm extremely fond of. But we just have to wait to find it. Burnout's not it either. Although, can't really complain about having another burnout. Ooh, a new enemy and two Mikados. That right there is a merman. The merman has a lance attack and also knows water magic. So guess what I really don't want to have happen? The water magic. Luckily, the Mikados are still the Mikados, and I really couldn't give a rat's ass about them. Ah! Right there, I slipped and I hit the circle button. I told you, once that counter happens, you start second-guessing yourself every single time. Every single time. Well, at any rate, the merman is not too bad. Honestly, as long as you don't get exposed to that magic attack, you're okay with him. He does a Spirit Frost, if you're wondering. Ah, there it is! Fuck! Get used to that. That is only one of two additions, I think, in the entire game where this actually becomes a huge headache for me. So, I'll fail that consistently. Also, no, I'm not really worried about Dart's HP getting to dangerous levels. Because, when and if I get that item, I'll basically have an impromptu way to get myself healed up. And it looks like it's going to be on the next screen, over to the left. And this boat's really damn slow. Alright, one of these two items is it. I'm sure of it. So, looks like we'll find out in the next battle. After the next battle. Oh boy. Crocs ahoy. Wow. two pellets and darkets that level up for Burning Rush, the new addition. Now, if Volcano is a low SP, oh wow, I have 32 items already. Catches up on you, don't it? Alright, time for me to get rid of these two charm potions, which I don't care for. I did not expect to get pellets from the Crocs. I didn't even know you could get pellets from the Crocs, actually. But I'll tell you what, I'm happy I did. Those pellets are pretty useful for a future boss fight. So, hip hip hooray. Anyway, this is the item I'm looking for, the Magic Stone of Signet. If you throw this at an enemy, it cannot act for 3 turns. And a stun guard, which, has its uses, I suppose, but kind of is the farthest thing from my mind at this point. But the Magic Stone of Signet is a specialty item that is extremely rare. I think there maybe is one more in existence in this game. But just having it is such a huge help for random encounters. The problem is it doesn't work against bosses, but if it did, that'd be kind of cheap. So it basically functions as a sword of revealing light to random encounter enemies, which is nice, very nice. I'll show it off first battle I get. You really don't have an excuse for wanting to get rid of it. Because honestly, it provides such a huge advantage in battle, why the hell would you care enough to get rid of it? You just wouldn't. It's too important. Anyway, there is one more enemy here, I believe, but it doesn't seem to want to pop up. Which is fine. Because it's time for me to show off the Magic Signet Stone! And it says repeated use. That's the other nice thing about it. Which means I can only use it once in battle. But after the battle is over, I'll have it again. And I can use it again and again and again and again. Like I said, this thing's fantastic. See already, it's taking effect. That guy couldn't move. And because of this, you can actually use it to give yourself an impromptu healing period that otherwise you may not have. So, there's many, many applications to this. Please note that despite this, they can still counter you. Don't ask how that works. I have no idea. I would think cannot move means cannot move means cannot move, but what do I know? Anyway, time to send this guy packing. And I'll switch to that new edition of darts. So, Burning Rush, as I said, high SP, low damage. Starts off at 30 SP and damage of 150. That damage will never go any higher than 150. It takes 2 hits, and other than getting used to the little hitch before the second attack, it really is very easy to follow. But the SP, when this is done, goes up to 102. So if you want to know if that thing has any use, the answer is yes. Absolutely. And because we can't have Shanna ever prove that she's powerful at all, not only are you the weakest party member I have at this point and have virtually no redeeming value since you can't do additions and you have very low HP and have no durability to speak of, now you are going to twist your ankle. Oh, God. Like I said, the game goes out of its way in the first disc, seemingly, to make Shadow look as useless as humanly possible. Which is horrible. Oh, God. God almighty, Shanna, why are you so useless at this point in the game? I don't even hate Shanna as a character. I'm not saying this because to hate on her. This isn't one of those cases. I just feel horrible for her. But really, the only reason I ever consider using Shanna at this point is really because I can. That really is the only reason. And because of the magic of going to the next screen, the ankle's okay. Dart, you must carry magical piggyback rides or something. Because I remember when I twisted my ankle a few times, my ankle looked like a baseball. I made the even stupider decision to try to play on it. And it never properly healed. So my left ankle still looks bigger than my right ankle to this day. A little bit of did you know about me. Anyway, next place we gotta go is an active volcano because reasons. This just feels like one of those obligatory, hey, you gotta enter a volcano at some point dungeons. It's got pretty haunting music to it. I like it. What's that? Let's see, it's shaking. And it's the volcano of Volud. That is Firebird. An original name, if I do say so myself, guys. I guess you couldn't have named it Moltres, though. That was a raid taken, I believe. Can we just let it go? It's up to him. Firebird. Really, guys? That's like if our next boss was a blue slime or something, we just call it Blue Thing. Honestly. Firebird. Pah! Couldn't have given it any name at all? Nothing? Nada? There wasn't anything available to it. Anyway. Firebird will leave us alone for the time being, so let's just continue on. On a merry way and not give a rat's ass about it. Spear Frost. Okay, we could use that. Because in that volcano, of course, what is there? Fire-type enemies left and right. And we're going to start off with the salamanders. So, these guys are kind of durable. But other than that, they'll go down quickly. I believe they have a stunning attack, if I remember right. Yep, right there. That was their stunning attack. It's a little charge. You saw those white bubbles pop up above Rose? That means he has an active chance to stun you. Doesn't mean he will, but... There's the Burning Rush in action, by the way. Like I said, it's pretty damn weak, but... I would still take the time to level it up, if you can. And he also does a Gushing Magma, just to really piss you off. Obviously, not good to really anybody. You know, not good to Lavis, but Dart and Rose can pretty much house it because Dart's a fire type and Rose is Rose. Rose is a badass. Rose throughout this game is going to be pretty much a badass, but especially in this first disc for the first few levels. She's just head and shoulders above everybody else right now. And there really is no particular argument against her at this point. Except maybe the addition. Volcano. And this is going to be a recurring problem throughout the game. So. Let's see. What do we want to discard today? Well, I really don't need spirit potions. I really should be using them up. And six angel prayers is good. Burnouts. Kind of don't need... I don't really need burnouts right now. Magic Pellets and Spear Frosts are just fine for right now. There isn't a water type enemy that really is of note at this point. Actually, I don't think there even is a notable one in the entire first disc. I mean, that Sandora soldier you saw, I wouldn't consider him that notable. Anyway, if you go over here, you can get a Panic Guard. So Panic Guard will protect you against confusion, which is a pretty evil status ailment. Also, one that not too many enemies employ. Okay, Fire Spirits. These guys are weak. All they really do is attack you melee with a very weak melee, and they can heal their own HP a little bit. They're kind of evasive, though. But other than that, they provide nothing. Burning rush. Nothing at all. See? That's all they do. I mean, they're laughably weak. See? Laughably weak. Also, I didn't really say this at all, but Rose's fighting pose and her finishing poses are probably the coolest of any of the party members in the game, in my opinion. Something about Rose's poses I just like way more than the others. It's like even her standing pose, just where she just casually has the sword up and ready to go. I've always liked that. I could be biased though, Rose is actually my favorite character in the game. Reasons why it will become more evident as the game goes along. She sort of functions as a second protagonist in this game, so that's kind of why I have kept Mum on her throughout, other than her battle prowess. This room right here is actually pretty unique. You see how we have a red thing right there? Well, because the whole come in contact with enemy thing takes effect. If a fist jumps over you, the battle starts. And you start facing these magma fishes. Magma fish, rather. Fishes is not a word. Slight evasiveness, but nothing major. Pretty blah attack. They can do burnout, which sucks, and they're kind of quick. But overall, they are very, very weak. Convenient ways to level up. So, what I'm going to do is I'm probably just going to use this opportunity to heal up, because our next boss is actually very close. So, give me a moment before I tear this guy limb from limb. There we go. Got a healing potion out of it, and I used the opportunity to just heal myself completely. So, with that in mind, let's continue onward. Actually, it's around this point that I usually have level 2 Dragoon, level 2 Dragoons at with a Dart and Rose. You'll always face two magma fishes if this ever happens. It's always two. And they're still weak as ever, so there's really no redeeming value to them. Be right back. Okay, I'm definitely finding one more of these. Guys in the game really did not give me a chance to get out of the way. Alright. I was gonna say, Lavitz only needs two experience points to level up. I'm giving him those two, right now. Now that we got that out of the way, let's get out of here. And mystical music, which means something is going on. And of course, naturally involves Shanna, because Shanna is basically the squeaky wheel getting more and more grease as the game goes along. It's ridiculous. Okay, Shanna, another horrible thing happened to you. Looks like a stone statue. What the heck is this thing? I have no idea. Don't go near. Oh boy. What's going on? Listen to this Farage is still alive. Farage? Okay. You know about the Dragoon campaign, right? The wing is round numbers, so they created this. They use this creature called Farage as their trump card in the war. So they were the Wingley's version of the dragon. So how can this thing still be alive after 11,000 years? I don't know, but it is. Either way, we gotta curb stomp this guy. So, yep, our next fight is against Farage. Also, the third boss theme, easily my favorite. Actually gives you the feel of a really cool boss fight. Like, it really does. This one right here really gives me a feel of an intense boss fight. Like, an oh, this is going to happen. Unfortunately, though, Virage really doesn't provide that. Virage is sort of like a mid-bossy type enemy. Not terrible. Not great, though. Now, if you want to take care of Virage, you can attack the body, which I'm not even sure what the hell that does. There's almost no point to it. You can attack the arm. The arm has about 30 hit points, but it regenerates after a few turns, so it really isn't worth your time. In order to kill it, you gotta attack the head, because that kind of is the case like any enemy. If you take out the head, take out the head of the snake, then it dies off. You know how it is. Anyway, this is where we go ahead and use our Dragoons, because this is where it matters. And I got to show you Astral Drain, the most powerful magic attack through the first disc. It's only 25% a single, but because Rose has such a fantastic magic attack, she actually will do more attack, more damage than Dart's Flame Shot. Astral Drain. But be warned, even though Astral Drain is fantastic now, it will wear itself out. In later discs, Astral Drain will become pathetically weak compared to other options on the table. But 64 damage right now? Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Virage's most devastating attack, though, other than that melee that he can do, which does quite a bit of damage, he has a head laser attack, which does more damage. So that really is the thing you gotta watch out for. Probably more than anything else. Anyway, even though he's sort of a mid-bossy type boss, I'd still send everything in the kitchen sink at him. He's easily the most threatening thing here, so why wouldn't you? Also, don't ask me how all these attacks are somehow hitting the head, despite the fact, you know, the head is about 10 feet up and our characters haven't jumped an inch off the ground. It doesn't make sense to me at all. Also, good time to use the attack ball. What random thing will we get this time? It could be great, it could be bad. You sort of can tell from what you see in the Ezthron. Sparknet. Alright, not bad. Like I said, you really don't know what it is. It can be anything on the table. I'm just glad it wasn't a status ailment inducing thing, because those things never work on bosses. Bosses are immune to status ailments. So, I mean, I'm pretty good with that. Luckily, he has not gone to the head laser yet, which does way more damage than that melee attack you see. Heck, he might not even get it off at all, and you know what? That's perfectly fine by me. I don't really want to wait around with this guy. But if you do see it... looks like we won't have to worry about it. Nice! The head laser probably would do about 75 damage. You know, I'd say about 60 to 75 damage to whoever it strikes. Well, single person, but, you know, still deadlier than anything else you had to worry about. Also, that guy is pissed off that he just got owned. Crocmire called. He wants his death back. Also, isn't it interesting that Rose is just still casually standing there on the edge? Like, whatever. You don't scare me, Virage. Just casually walks away. Everybody else is like, run away, run away, run away! That thing is scary! Rose is a badass. What can we say? Anyway. another level up for Rose, and one for Shannon. Like I said, you do get levels even if you're not in the active party, but you do get less experience. So that does work against you. Anyway, there's only one way to go, and that's through here. And unfitting music is unfitting in a volcano. As this guy is caught up on something. This is the music that plays when you're trying to rescue somebody, apparently. Okay, I'm joking about it. This actually is this guy's theme song, but hey. It's still kind of comical to hear. But anyway, for doing this, we got a sapphire pin. This guy's name is Davis. Spelled backward, that's Sabad. Not like it means anything, but hey, who cares? He was told he could find a burning gem around here, so he came and, well, this happened to him. He's an antique dealer. So that sapphire pin we got, basically, if we are attacked by magic, we will regain MP, and it's 4 MP, I believe. I'm not sure if it scales up per Dragoon level or not. The reason I say I'm not sure is because you probably figured out, hey, I don't use it too often. Because I don't think there really is a need to. I don't think really, you don't really accumulate that much MP with it, so I never found it to be a viable option. Honestly, that really is the truth. So, with that in mind, you know what? I think it's time for me to actually get the mediocre one out. Why not? Right? Might as well, after all. So, like I said, Shanna's an awful fighter, so whatever happens to her, kind of like a Devil May Care attitude I'm having towards this. And it's going to be kind of convenient because as soon as we get over here, Firebird shows up. Firebird, the most dastardly name of all the named enemies in this volcano. Also like the Team Flame effect. Yep, we gotta fight this guy. So you fight two bosses in quick succession, but Virage is tougher than this guy. So this is sort of like a cool down Firebird fight. It's a cool down fight for an enemy that is pretty powerful. Shanna, having absolutely no use other than item throwing at this point, Spear of Frosts. Let's start. Beautiful. 93 damage. Shanda does have one thing. Fantastic magic attack and magic defense. So Firebird here really does not have much.
Yes.
I mean, he has a few attacks. That melee attack you saw, which really isn't that bad. He has an attack all that's kind of blah as well. He has a magic dive bomb attack, which will hit everybody. And he has one special attack that really does damage. But if he keeps pecking me to death, you know what? That's probably the best I could hope for. So, I'll take it. Match time. The problem with constantly mashing your buttons, your wrist gets stiff. Like, my wrist gets stiff like you wouldn't believe after doing a few of those. Mainly because I'm not used to it, because less games use button mashing now. Which is probably a good thing. I mean, that's sort of like the... That's sort of like a Mario Party-esque thing. Up, oh, here's the magic attack all. Thankfully, because I have three pretty good characters, that really doesn't mean anything. Lavitz would take quite a bit of damage from it, though. Make no mistake about it. I remember this was around those days where they really, really tried to put as many minigames in as humanly possible. So you get games like Mario Party and the like, where they make you do pretty stupid things. Like, Mario Party, the first one, for example, I remember they had so many of those rotate the thumbstick routines which ended up being taken out because it was actually hurting people. And if you're mocking people for that, don't. I actually literally burned a hole in my palm of my hand from it. So I can attest to it, personally, that it ain't a hoax. It legitimately did hurt. It had a little tiny hole there. It was actually kind of comical. Luckily, he doesn't seem to want to do his other attacks, which is nice. He has one special attack that you kind of have to watch out for, though. Let's see if he pulls it off. No, he's going back to the dive bomb. All right. Keep the dive bomb. Yeah, that works for me. That works for me. I don't even have to get my Dragoons up at this point. It's amazing that he really does not want to use his really good attacks. Not like I'm complaining. Here it is. This is his special attack right here. He comes back and he sends out 4 burning rocks. When this happens, you want to make sure that you destroy the rocks at all costs, because they do damage. They hurt like heck. Or you can choose to guard and just really try to endure it. I would just get rid of the volcano balls altogether if you can, because that just means less that he'll send after you. They don't have much HP, so you could try to get rid of it, but as you see, pretty damaging. And the other attack that he hasn't done is an attack all, like, where he screeches at you and causes some rocks to pop up over you or something. It doesn't do much damage at all, so hence why I'm not intimidated at all by it. He should be dead shortly. Like, right now-ish. And there you go. 1 Firebird disposed of. And we got a Red Eye Stone, which I presume to be the burning stone that Davos was talking about. And with that, level 2 for Rose. So now she got 20 more MP and also Death Dimension, a new magic attack. And we also got as a reward a cringeworthy pun from Dart. Great job, Dart. You truly are the Robin Williams of our generation. Rest in peace, Robin Williams. But with that, 50 gold, and we could also talk to Davis and actually get some items from him, which is nice. Oh, whoops. I didn't want to do that. If you're wondering how much a sapphire pin goes for, you could sell for 500 gold, which is pretty awesome. Like I said, I really don't care for it, so you know what I'm doing? I'm selling that damn thing back to him. Yes, it's insulting, it's like re-gifting in Seinfeld or something, but I'm doing it. Anyway, I really don't need the power wrist either. But you can also get a few things like these dancing rays and pellets here. Like I said, the pellets you're going to need, so I would take them along. 2's probably good enough. And you get a dancing ray, which will be a light-based attack for everybody. You don't really need that, because it really isn't a prevalent dark enemy for a very long while. Matter of fact, I'm not even going to bother, so let's get out of here. And with that in mind, we're actually going to head to our next dungeon after this battle. And we face an enemy that was in Volcano that we did not face. The Red Hot. Throws lava at you. Kind of like the slime from the limestone cave. But goes without saying, he's pretty damn weak. And also, either in the marshland or in there, I forget which, there actually was a sea dragon there that would actually, that could use fire magic on you. Anyway, that's gonna conclude this part. And next time, we're gonna head into the dragon's nest, the next dungeon. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.